morning, Rabotai. Now that the summer is slowly coming to an end, the Shkia, sunset, is getting a little bit earlier. Should have spoken about it a little bit earlier in the summer, but anyway, when people do early Shabbat, many people throughout the summer, they accept Shabbat early. They don't want to wait too late until Shkia. They accept Shabbat early. Now, even though you do that, a person might do that every week, it's not that if you do it one week, you must do it every week. That's not the case. And even if a person prays in a Bet Knesset Kavua, and one week he doesn't want to, he wants to go to a different Bet Knesset, he's not bound. A person can choose that week, even though his regular shul always does early Shabbat, that doesn't bind him to accept Shabbat. He can choose that week, that Lil Shabbat, I'm going to pray in another Bet Knesset that does regular a little bit later, and that's okay, it doesn't bind him. One thing that a person has to keep into consideration, though, is that the Shulchan Aruch brings down that when a majority of the city has already accepted Shabbat, even if this person has not, the halacha is that he accepts Shabbat against his will. Shabbat is forced on him. So there are certain places, again, it's hard to know exactly, but there are certain places that during the summer, almost every shul is doing early Shabbat, such that everybody, men, women, and children, would be dragged along with a majority of the town, a majority of the city that's accepting Shabbat. So over there, even though that person wants to do later Shabbat, you have to know, if most of the shuls in the city, in the area, are doing earlier Shabbat and they're mekabel Shabbat, let's say by whenever, 7, 7.15, 7.30, whenever it is, by the time that most of the Jews in the city have already accepted earlier Shabbat, that person, even though he's not ready, by force, he accepts Shabbat. And it's not only for men, it's for women. It's an interesting dynamic that sometimes, I'm not sure exactly that it's exactly everybody or most of the shuls in the area, but many shuls do. So this is something to take into consideration. I've never had 100% clarity on it to know what exactly everybody does, but it's something certainly to keep in mind during the summer months. Yom Tov and Shabbat Shalom.